Yesterday, we have learned practice set 1.2 and we are going to learn practice set 1.3. But before we are going to learn practice set 1.3, we have learned some of the basic things which is required to solve the practice set 1.3. So, afterwards, you are seeing the basic things which is required to solve the practice set 1.3. So, which is that basic things? Just see. So here is first, they are said, conditional statement. So what is meaning of conditional statement? Conditional statement means a statement which is done with help of if and then. That statement is called as the conditional statement. So what is the conditional statement? A conditional statement is a statement which is done with help of if and then. That is called as the conditional statement. Are you understand what I say? Conditional statement means a statement which is done with help of if and then. That statement is called as the conditional statement. Means if I won the lottery, then I purchase a car. This is a conditional statement. Okay? If I won the 1 crore lottery, then I purchase a big bungalow. So such a way conditions are called as the conditional statement. Because in that statement we are using if and then. Another, if I am a winner, then I will get trophy. So such a way you are used if and then so many times and different statements. So that statements are called as the conditional statements. Are you understand? So conditional statement means the statement in which they are using the if and then. Such a statement is called as the conditional statement. So this is basic things because we are used in 1.4 if and then. Then when you are using the if, so when you are using the if and sentence up to then, that statement is called as the antecedent. That statement is called as the antecedent. Means suppose I will say one of the examples. If I won the lottery. So that is antecedent, won the lottery. Then I purchase car. So that is consecutive because they are using then. So after then, whatever be the statement, that is called as consecutive. And after if, whatever be the statement, that is called as antecedent. Are you understand what I said? After if, whatever be the statement, that is called as antecedent. And after then, whatever be the statement, that is called as consequent. I am just saying you one of the example. Again, that example I am repeating here. If I pass, then I get a job. So if I pass the exam, this is the antecedent. If I pass the exam, this is the antecedent. Then I got a job. So then I got a job. It is a consequent. Are you understand? So that is the main thing, means after if, whatever be the statement is called as the antecedent, and after then, whatever be the statement, that is called as the consequent. So that is the one example is given to you. This is the general statement. So general statement, two intersecting lines are contained in one plane. What they have said, this is the general statement. There is not using if and there is not using then. Okay, so this is the general statement. Two intersecting lines are contained in a plane. What they are saying? Two intersecting lines are contained in a plane. Mean there is a plane, and in that plane, they are having the line, that lines are intersecting each other. Okay, that lines are intersecting each other. This is the general statement. Mean in the plane, they are having the two lines, that two lines are intersecting each other. It is a general statement. Then this sentence we can write with the conditional statement. So what is the condition? Two intersecting lines. This is the condition. Okay. This is the condition. Condition means what? What is the situation is there? There are the two lines and that two lines are intersecting. This is the condition. So whatever be the condition, that condition can be write with the help of it. Are you understand what I say? Whatever be the condition, that condition can be write with help of if. So what is the condition here? So condition is two condition is two intersecting lines. This is the condition. And so what is the condition that can be used with if? So here is your only case, if two lines intersect each other, if two lines intersect each other, then they are contained in a plane. Then they are contained in a plane. Are you understand how can I use here if and then? See, where I use if, whatever be the condition, there I use if. So what is the condition? Condition is two intersecting line are contained in a plane. So when the two intersecting line is the condition. So what happen if the two intersecting lines, they are intersect each other? It is a situation. Okay. So that is right with help of if. So how can you write that? See here, if two lines intersect each other, ekmekena te intersect kartat, intersect each other, here is the condition is n, then what happen? If they are intersect each other, then what happen? They are having in a plane, okay? Then they are contained in one plane, okay? So here is your, remove this R and here you are kept, then they are contained in a plane. Are you understand? If don't understand, then see. What is the condition? Two intersecting lines, they are intersect each other. That is the condition, okay? So condition can be write with help of if. So we are write with help of if. So if two lines intersect each other, this is the condition, each other. After each other, there is what? R. So you remove this R and kept there then. Then, after the lines set and don't it. So there are the lines. So we are say they. R is removed and there is kept then. They are contained in one name. Okay. Such a way we are using here if and then. Then converse of statement. That must be right. So a general statement is given to you. If two lines intersect, then they are in a plane. So see, I am take the condition is remain as it is. With general statement, I am not changed. The general statement I can keep as it is. Why? Because you are not confused. If I am taking that example, all is become a mixture and you are nothing understand anything. So I am taking only one statement, and that's with the help of that statement, we are see the conditional statement, then we are going to see the converse of statement. So here is general statement. If two lines intersect, then they are in a plane. Okay. So here is converse. If two lines are in a plane, what they are said, if two lines are in a plane, then they intersect each other. So when you write converse, in converse we are write opposite. Means in if you write here situation, if you write here state, prove what you want to prove, that is write in after, before it. Means in converse you write after if what you want to prove, that is right. So if two lines are in a plane, okay, there those line eka plane madhe astil tar, if two lines are in a plane, then they are intersect each other. There two lines eka plane madhe astil tar tya doghi ekmekana intersect kartat, aso converse hai. म्हणजे कॉन्वर्स मध्ये आणि स्टेटमेंट फॉर्म मध्ये काय फरक आहे? स्टेटमेंट कंडिशनल फॉर्म मध्ये काय होतं? तर इफ नंतर आपण कंडिशन मेंशन करतो आणि देन नंतर व्हाट यू वांट टू प्रूव दैट यू आर राइट. बट इन कॉन्वर्स वी आर डूइंग अपोजिट ऑफ दिस. इन कॉन्वर्स वी आर डूइंग आफ्टर इफ वी आर राइट व्हाट यू वांट टू प्रूव एंड आफ्टर देन व्हाट इज गिवन, दैट इज राइट. सो दिस इज इन कॉन्वर्स. सो दिस इज द मेन डिफरेंस बिटवीन द कंडिशनल फॉर्म एंड द स्टेटमेंट. So if some of the students still don't understand it, and again explaining that in conditional form we can write if, and after if we are write condition. What is the condition there? That condition is mentioned after if, and after then we are write there what you want to prove. So this is in conditional form. But when you are writing the converse statement, in the converse statement we are doing opposite of this. So in the converse statement we are doing that after if we are write there what is prove, that you write here, and after then you write what is condition. So this is the main difference between converse statement and the conditional statements. Then here is the main difference is we will see the difference between conditional statement and a converse statement. And in converse statement, there is one of the thing that is what, that is not here, and this is proved, means this is already happened here also. See what is given. If property is true, what is the property? Property is two line intersect. This is the property. Okay, that two lines, they are intersect each other. This is the property, and that property is true, correct property. This is not a false. Then its converse may or may not be true. But if the property is correct, property is true, but whatever we write the converse, that converse may not be correct. So this condition is happen here also, in this condition also. Here is what they are said, if two lines are in a plane, then they intersect each other. So what is the converse said? In a plane, the line must be intersect each other. But that is the wrong. So here is they are said, if your property is true, but your converse may not be true. म्हणजे प्रत्येक वेळी तुमचं कॉन्वर्स बरोबरच असेल असं म्हणता येणार नाही. अँड हेअर ऑल्सो युअर कॉन्वर्स इज रॉंग इन दिस एक्झाम्पल ऑल्सो, बिकॉज दे आर सेड इफ टू लाईन्स इंटरसेक्ट इच अदर देन दे आर हॅव्हिंग इन अ सिंगल प्लेन. सो दॅट इज अ रॉंग दॅट कॅन बी आय एक्सप्लेन यू विथ हेल्प ऑफ द डायग्राम. इन दॅट प्लेन दे आर हॅव्हिंग द टू लाईन्स अँड दॅट टू लाईन्स आर पॅरेलल टू इच अदर, दे आर नॉट इंटरसेक्ट टू इच अदर. सो this converse is totally wrong. That can be proved in this diagram. You can see this diagram. It is a single plane. Okay. In that plane, this line and see this line. So there are these two lines. Here is the segment, because there is not show the arrow. So here is this segment and this segment. These two segments are parallel to each other. Line also we can draw such a way. They are also parallel to each other. But so there is the two lines. They are parallel to each other. They are having in a single plane. And in converse, what they are said? They are said when two lines are intersect each other, then they are having in a single plane. So I am saying, whatever be the converse say, that is not always correct. That may not be true. That must be false. And that is happened in this example. I am sure with this proof that there are the two lines or there are the two segments. That two segments are parallel to each other. And they are having in a single plane. Are you understand? So whatever we say here, if property is true, then its converse may not be true. And this is happened in this example. पडलेगा तुम्हाला का मराठी सांगायला लागेल. इथे त्यांनी असं म्हटलंय की दोन लाईन इंटरसेक्ट करतात, त्याच दोन लाईन एका प्लेन मध्ये असतात असं तो म्हणतोय. परंतु ही त्याची प्रॉपर्टी आहे की त्या दोन लाईन इंटरसेक्ट करतात म्हणून त्या प्लेन मध्ये राहतात. परंतु हे रॉंग आहे, कारण त्याचं उदाहरण बाजूला दाखवलंय. बघा हा एक सेगमेंट आहे, हा एक सेगमेंट आहे, हे दोन्ही सेगमेंट एकमेकांना इंटरसेक्ट करत नाही, दे आर पॅरलल टू इच अदर, बट दे आर हॅव्हिंग इन ए प्लेन. सो दिस इज अ रॉंग. आर यू अंडरस्टँड? देन वी आर गोइंग टू सी द अनदर, व्हॉट इज द प्रूफ अँड व्हॉट इज द पॉस्ट्युलेट्स. सो हेअर इज द पॉस्ट्युलेट्स. द सेल्फ एव्हिडंट ज्योमेट्रिकल स्टेटमेंट विच आर एक्सेप्टेड बाय ऑल are called as postulates. So what they are said? Self-evident. Self-evident means they are proved himself. They are not proved by another person or they are not proved by with help of another diagram. So that can be proved by itself. So they are called as the self-evident. Okay. So they are called as the self-evident means whatever be their property, that property can be proved by itself. Okay. So the self-evident geometrical statement. So what is that geometrical statement which are accepted by all are called as postulates. So that statement which are accepted by all is called as the postulate. So which are they? Can you say me? Triangle having three sides. This is one of the postulates. Sum of the angle of triangle is 180 degree. Then quadrilateral sum is 360 degree. Angular measure of circle is 360 degree. Such a way they are having the so many postulates, and that postulate accepted by all, and no one can give challenge to them. They are said, yeah, it is correct. The sum of angle of triangle is 180, sum of angle of quadrilateral is 360, sum of angular measure, sorry, and the angular measure of the circle is 360. So that all postulates are so these all postulate whatever I explaining you that all persons can be considered it is correct. So that is called as postulate. That is not required to prove that, that is already proved. So that is called as postulate. Because see, suppose I will give one of the example, but you are take as a example, don't be make it issue. So see, suppose I will give one of the example that all person know if you take poison then you are die. So can you say, sir please I want to check it whether I am die or not die. So I am taken poison and see, oh I am not die. Is it possible? No, no person can be make a experiment on itself, because that is already proved that when some of the person take poison, that person can be dead. Okay, so that is also a postulate. Such in geometry, sum of angle of triangle is 180, sum of angle of quadrilateral is 360, angular measure of circle is 360, and so many postulates are there. Then, so this is a postulate. Then theorem means what? Theorem means the property which is proved with help of the postulates, that is called as the theorem. So theorem means, another way we can say, theorem means the property proved by logically are called as theorem. Logically means, suppose if you want to prove that the three points having on a same line, that you want to prove. So what can you do? First you can draw the line, then you are giving name A, B, C. Then you are taken distance, AB is equal to 5, BC is equal to 5, distance AC is equal to 10. Yeah, so distance AC is equal to 10, so distance AB plus distance BC, 5 plus 5 is 10. So A dash, B dash, C, they are collinear points. Okay, such a way you are logically give reason with each and every statement, and then you are say it is so. Okay. So that is called a logically proof, and that is whatever be the logically proof, that property which property you are logically proof is called as the theorem. So here is the Euclid. Euclid is the geometric mathematicians, and that Euclid can be give first 5 postulates. Okay, so that 5 postulates can be considered that correct. So we can see one by one postulates. So there is a one of the postulates, there are infinite lines passing through a point. So this is the one postulate. There is the single point. There are an infinite line passing through a point. Means they are said if you draw one point, so from that one point you can draw infinite line. You can draw infinite line. You cannot count how many lines are passing through from that single point. So this postulate made by Euclid. So this postulate is correct. You can see here. So this is the point A. That can be seen here. This is the point A. Okay. So from that point A, we can draw infinite lines, and that infinite lines can be passed though from this A. Okay. But some of the students said, sir, it is countable. Yeah, it is countable because I'm not draw so many lines. Here is, you can draw so many lines that lines are uncountable. So if you want to try, you can do it and say, is it possible to count? Then show me. So that much line can be passed those single points. But remember that from single points there are infinite lines can be passed away. So this is the first postulates of Euclid, and Euclid postulates are coming in exam. So remember, all of students, you must be know that all postulates of Euclid. So first postulates of Euclid is there are infinite lines passed through a point, single point. So this point is A, that can be shown here, and after that single point we can draw infinite lines. Okay, so this is the second postulates, first postulate. Then we are going to learn second postulates. So there is the second postulate, what is given by Euclid. So Euclid said that there is one and only one line passing those 2 points. What did Euclid said? Euclid said if there are the 2 points, so from that 2 points we can draw single line. That is said by Euclid, not by me. Okay? So Euclid can be said that if they are having the 2 points, so from that 2 points we can draw single line. So see how it is possible. See, this is the point A, suppose. This is the point A and this is the point B. Okay, so from the two points, we can draw a single line. So this is the postulates of Euclid. Euclid said, if there are the two points, so from that two points, we can draw a single line. From one point, we can draw infinite line. From two points, we can draw only one line. This is Euclid's second postulate and it is very too easy understand. Then third Euclid postulate, whatever it may be. So here is the giving name A and B, because A point and B point. So from the point A and B, we can draw only one segment or only one line, because from two points, you can draw one segment or one line from two points. Okay. Then we are going to learn postulate third of Euclid. A circle of given radius can be drawn by taking any point as its center. So what is said by Euclid? Euclid said you can have a center, and that center, the given radius, suppose you are said 2 cm radius is given. Suppose you can take A is the center of the circle and take 2 cm distance in your rounder and you draw the circle such a way. Okay, so here is, you draw the circle. So this circle is drawn. Suppose this is the center point. I am not giving the name, but see, here is the A point, and with A point the radius is taken 2 cm, and I am draw this circle. Okay, so they are saying taking any point as a center. So you can take any point. Here I take A, here is I take B, here is I take C. Means that point you can take anywhere and you can draw a circle. Okay, so here is, by taking any point, A point, B point, C point, D points, you can draw a circle of given radius. There is not a, you are saying that, oh, only you are taking O and taking 2 cm distance, then and then you draw a circle. No, it is not so. You can take any center point, A center point, B, anything, any center points of given radius. So you can easily draw the circle. So this is the third postulate of Euclid. Then four postulates of Euclid. All right angles are congruent to each other. What all right angle? What is the right? Right angle means what? Right angle means 90-degree angle. So 90-degree angle, they are said. Okay, right 90-degree angle they are said. So 90-degree angle or 90-degree, that's angle, they are congruent to each other. I am drawing a triangle for this example. Three. The congruent means what? Right means you are understand 90-degree. Congruent means what? Congruent means whose angular measure is correct. Means whose angular measure are equal. If it is 90, another is 90. If it is 60, another is 60. It is for another example, say, right angle is 90-degree, I know that. But what is congruent? If this angle is 90-degree, another is 90-degree, then they are congruent. Okay. If this is 60, another is 60, then they are congruent. If it is 30, another is 30, then they are congruent. So this condition is happen here. I am draw here right angle triangle. So this is PN and this is another draw XYZ. So see, this is the right angle triangle. Don't consider this hypotenuse. Okay? And this hypotenuse don't consider. You are only take the angle PAN. This A must be capital, PAN. It is the right angle. So this is 90-degree. Then X, Y and Z. This is also 90-degree. So Y angle is 90-degree and A angle is 90-degree. So these two angles are 90-degree. So they are congruent. So whatever be the said Euclid is correct. Euclid said that all right angles are congruent to each other. That is correct. Because they are having 90-degree. So they are congruent. Then we are going to learn Euclid's last postulate, fifth postulate, whatever it may be. If two interior angles form on one side of a transversal, what they are said? They are said to me must be formed two interior angles, and that two interior angles can be formed one sides of the sides. Okay, one sides of two lines adds up to less than two right angles. Then the lines produced in that direction intersect each other. Okay. So this is one of the line, this is the another line, this is the transversal. So it is the 90 degree angles. Then this is A angle, this is L, this is M, this is B, and this is M. So see, this L line and this M line, they are parallel to each other. Okay. The N is the transversal. So this N is the transversal. So the N is the transversal. So the transversal sides at same sides. This angle A and this angle B. Here is this angle A and this angle B, 90 degree. I am giving name here only, but it is 90 degree, it is 90 degree. Because they are said 90 degree. Two lines add up to less than two right angles. Two right angles. So here is, this is 90 degree, this is 90 degree. So if you draw line from A point, such a way going. So if you draw line from B point, such a way going. Then this, see, suppose I am draw line from this A point, they are going from this route. Suppose I draw a line from these B points, they are going. So they are intersect each other. So this is the fifth postulate, and that is also correct. Okay? So such a way we can learn Euclid's five postulates, and that Euclid's five postulates is very important for exam. Then we are going to learn practice set 1.3. So first here we are see all the questions, and afterwards we can see the questions and answers. What are we asking? Write the following statement, if and then what? If and then what? So all those questions that is written there. So here is, see, the first question here is you use if and then. The opposite angle of a parallelogram are congruent. What they are saying? The opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. So when the angles are congruent, when they are parallelogram. Okay. So parallelogram is what? Parallelogram is a triangle? No. Parallelogram is a quadrilateral. So what is the quadrilateral? So parallelogram is a quadrilateral. So with help of condition, we can say that if quadrilateral is a parallelogram. See, parallelogram is what? Quadrilateral. So here is we say if quadrilateral is a parallelogram. The quadrilateral code as a parallelogram as a. Condition is what? Parallelogram. So if quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then its opposite angles are congruent. Kasa ghetle baka ithun suru kele parallelogram pasun start kele. We have started from parallelogram, but what is the parallelogram? Parallelogram is the quadrilateral. Okay, parallelogram is a quadrilateral. So here is we write if a quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So here is we write if a quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then its opposite angles are congruent. Teva tache opposite angles congruent astat. So here is condition right, if parallelogram, if quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then what can you do? Then here is right, then the opposite angles are congruent. Are you understand? Then second, what is given? The diagonal of rectangle are congruent. Okay, this is given general form. The diagonal of rectangle are congruent. What is rectangle? What is rectangle? Rectangle is a quadrilateral. Right? Rectangle is a quadrilateral. So how can you say if quadrilateral is a rectangle? Okay. See, because your first, your aim is towards the rectangle. So your aim is towards the rectangle. So I am kept here rectangle. And ask the question, what is the rectangle? So I get the answer, rectangle is a quadrilateral. Okay. So rectangle is a quadrilateral, so you can write the condition with help of if. So you can write the condition with help of if. So if quadrilateral is a rectangle, then its diagonal are congruent. See here, such a way they are right. Rectangle, what is rectangle? Quadrilateral. So we can write if a quadrilateral is a rectangle, simple, is a rectangle, then what is they given? The diagonal are congruent. Then its diagonal are congruent. Are you understand? Such a way we are using if and then. This is look like bigger, but in an isosceles triangle, what is meaning of isosceles? Isosceles means that triangle two sides are congruent. That is called as isosceles. Are you understand what is meaning of isosceles? isosceles means that triangle whose sides are congruent. So that is called as isosceles triangle. The segment joining the vertex and midpoint of its the base is perpendicular to the base. What they are said in an isosceles triangle means triangles whose two sides are congruent. From that, if you draw perpendicular from its vertex, then that perpendicular from its vertex, where is that intersect the base, that is the midpoint, and that is perpendicular, means they are from a 90 degree angle. So what we say, it is a triangle. So we can say if an isosceles triangle, this is the condition, if a triangle is a isosceles. What is it? Triangle. Contour type of triangles are isosceles. So we can write conditions here. If a triangle is isosceles, if triangle is isosceles, okay, simple. Then remove this comma, and keep there only then, and keep there only then. Then the segment joining vertex and midpoint of the base is perpendicular to the base. So it is very simple. What can you say? Isosceles is a triangle. What is isosceles? It is triangle. So you are right. If triangle is isosceles, remove the comma and keep there only then segment and write all it is as it is. Such a way this conditional statement can be written. Then problem number second, write the converse of the following statement. So you want to write converse. So that all converse we have started here. So first, the alternate angle from by two parallel lines and their transversal are congruent. So what they are said, the alternate angles from, alternate angles which they are saying still there, the alternate angle from by two parallel lines, the lines are how parallel, two parallel lines and their transversal, so from their transversal are congruent. So they are said when the two lines are parallel, where alternate angles are congruent. Okay, so here is the right condition. If the alternate angle made by two lines and their transversal are congruent, then two lines are parallel. So after then what you want to prove, that is written, two lines are parallel. What is condition? If alternate angles are congruent, who is made the alternate angle? Alternate angle made by two lines. So only two lines make the alternate angle? No, with help of transversal they are making a alternate angle. So if alternate angle made by two parallel lines and their transversal are congruent, then the two lines are parallel. Okay, so first here, if we write what is given, if the alternate angle made by two lines and their transversal are congruent, then two lines are parallel. What is true is written after then. So I am explaining it with help of diagram also. So you can see, here is. So see, this is the line M and this is the line N. Okay. So this M line and this N line. Then this is the what? This is the transversal. So this L line is the transversal. So at the, so this M line, the L line intersect here. So there is forming B angle and that is the 50 degree. Then this L line go ahead and intersect L. So there is also forming C angle and angular measure of C is 50 degree. So this B angle and C angle, their angular measure are say 50-50. Their angular measure are same and they are alternate angle. So this B angle and C angle are alternate angle. They are congruent, easily understand. So I am right here 50 degree. Because congruent means angular measure are same. So I am showing that B is 50 and C is 50. But the B is the alternate angle of C. So this alternate angle made by who? M line and N line. And who? By transversal. If there is no transversal, there is no forming angles. Okay. So this M line and this N line there are two lines, and another third line is the transversal. So due to that, they are forming the B angle and C angle. So this B angle and C angle, they are alternate angle. So these alternate angles are congruent. So these lines are parallel to each other. Then two lines are parallel. Okay. Such a way here is written. Then the two lines are parallel. When two lines are parallel, the alternate angles made by two lines, M line and N line, and their transversal are congruent, then two lines are parallel. So which two lines are parallel? M and N. They are parallel. Are you understand? Second one, what is they are saying? If a pair of interior angle made by a transversal of two lines are supplementary, then the lines are parallel. What they said, if a pair of interior angle made by a transversal of two lines are supplementary, then the lines are parallel. So it is given, if two parallel lines are intersect by transversal, means there are the two parallel lines and that parallel line intersect by transversal, then the interior angle formed by the transversal are supplementary. So the interior angle formed by transversals are supplementary, they are said. So here is C. This is the two parallel line, L line and M line. They are parallel. And this is the transversal N. So this transversal N made interior angle A and interior angle B. So interior angle A 90 degree, interior angle B 90 degree. So sum of them is 180 degree. So they are supplementary to each other. So these two lines are parallel. Then problem number 4. The diagonal of a rectangle are congruent. Diagonal of a rectangle are congruent. What is rectangle? Rectangle is a quadrilateral. We can see last problem. Rectangle is a quadrilateral. If the diagonal of a quadrilateral, because rectangle is what? Quadrilateral. So here is we write. If the diagonal of a quadrilateral are congruent, if the diagonal of a quadrilateral are congruent, then what is it? It is rectangle. Then that quadrilateral is a rectangle. So here is the right condition. What condition? If diagonal of quadrilateral are congruent, it is the condition. Then what is it? That must be proved. Then that quadrilateral is a rectangle. So that can be clear. It is the rectangle. This is the diagonal. So this diagonal and this diagonal, see. This diagonal and this diagonal, they are congruent. And they are shown by the identical path. So it is a rectangle. So I am for the practice set 1.3. I hope that all the students can be understand it very well. So whether you are understand or not understand, that for checking for that, I am giving your homework. So you are completing this homework and send me. Okay? What is given there? The coordinates of some pairs of points are given below. Hence, find the distance between each pair. 3 to 6, find distance. Minus 9, minus 1, find distance. Okay? So, that homework you are completed and send to me on my WhatsApp number. And if you are understand what I taught you, and so you can do the like this channel and subscribe this channel. Because still, some of the students are remains, they are not subscribed the channel. So please subscribe this channel. Stay home. Stay safe.